Welcome to our video on the fascinating world of Phylum Annelida, a diverse group of segmented worms that live in a variety of habitats. In this video, we'll be exploring the salient features of this incredible phylum. Annelids are known for their segmented bodies, with each segment containing a similar set of organs and appendages. This unique body plan allows them to move and bend more easily than animals with unsegmented bodies. They also have setae, which are bristle-like structures on their body segments that help them to move through their environment and can also be used for defense. But that's not all. Annelids have a well-developed nervous system, with a pair of ganglia in each segment that are connected by a ventral nerve cord. They also have sensory organs, such as eyes, tentacles, and sensory bristles, which allow them to detect light, chemicals, and vibrations. Annelids can respire through their skin or gills, depending on the species. Some species also have specialized respiratory structures called parapodia, which are fleshy protrusions on the sides of their body segments. Annelids are incredibly diverse in their feeding habits. Some species are filter feeders, while others are predators that use their powerful jaws and proboscis to capture prey. They have a complete digestive system with a mouth, pharynx, esophagus, crop, gizzard, intestine, and anus. Most annelids are hermaphroditic, meaning they have both male and female reproductive organs. They can reproduce sexually by exchanging sperm with another individual or asexually by fragmentation or budding. Annelids are found in a wide range of habitats, including freshwater, marine, and terrestrial environments. They play an important role in many ecosystems, helping to break down organic matter and provide food for other animals. In summary, Phylum Annelida is a diverse group of segmented worms that are known for their unique body plan, well-developed nervous system, diverse feeding habits, and important role in many ecosystems. We hope you enjoyed learning about these amazing creatures. Now we will look into the scientific classification of earthworms and the reasons behind each classification. Let's start with the kingdom. Earthworms belong to the kingdom Animalia because they are multicellular, eukaryotic organisms that are heterotrophs, meaning they cannot produce their own food and rely on consuming other organisms. Moving on to the phylum, earthworms belong to the phylum Annelida because they are segmented worms. Their body is divided into many repeating segments that are separated by internal partitions called septa. They also have a complete digestive system, with a mouth at one end and an anus at the other. Now let's talk about the class. Earthworms belong to the class Clitellata because they possess a specialized reproductive structure called a clitellum. The clitellum is a thickened, saddle-shaped band that encircles the body of the worm and secretes a mucus cocoon in which eggs are deposited and fertilized. Earthworms in this class also lack parapodia, which are fleshy appendages that aid in movement and respiration in other annelids. Moving on to the order, earthworms belong to the order Haplotaxata because they lack bristle-like structures that are used for locomotion and anchorage in other annelids. Instead, earthworms in this order move using waves of muscular contractions that pass along their body. Now let's talk about the family. Earthworms belong to the family Lumbricidae because they are terrestrial worms that are commonly found in soil. They are also characterized by having a cylindrical body that is divided into many segments, each of which contains several pairs of nephridia, which are excretory organs that help to regulate the worm's internal environment. Moving on to the genus, earthworms belong to the genus Lumbricus because they have a flattened clitellum that is located near the anterior end of the body. They also possess a distinct dorsal blood vessel that runs along the length of the body, which helps to circulate blood and nutrients throughout the worm. Finally, let's talk about the species. The most commonly known species of earthworm is Lumbricus terrestris. This species is characterized by its reddish-brown color, cylindrical body, and length that can reach up to 30 centimeters. It is also commonly found in soil and is often used as bait by fishermen. In conclusion, earthworms are classified as multicellular, eukaryotic organisms that are segmented worms belonging to the phylum Annelida. Within this phylum, earthworms are classified as members of the class Clitellata, order Haplotaxata, family Lumbricidae, genus Lumbricus, and species Lumbricus terrestris. Each of these classifications is based on specific physical and behavioral characteristics that distinguish earthworms from other organisms. To know the classification and general characters of Nereis, please find the link in the video description. We have made a separate video on Nereis. Now we will classify leeches. In this part, we're going to uncover the different classifications of these slimy creatures and the reasons why they are classified as such. You may have heard of leeches being used in medicine, but did you know that they have a fascinating history and unique characteristics? Let's dive in and learn more. First off, leeches belong to the Animalia kingdom, meaning they are multicellular organisms that consume other organisms for their nutrition. But what makes leeches so unique is their ability to consume blood through a special sucker structure. Leeches fall under the phylum Annelida, which is a group of segmented worms. Unlike other annelids, leeches lack the bristle-like structures called setae, which are used for anchoring and locomotion. Leeches belong to the class Hirudinea because of their distinctive feeding structure. They have a sucker-like organ that allows them to latch onto their host and suck blood. In fact, leeches have been used for medicinal purposes for centuries, with some even using them to treat ailments like headaches and toothaches. Leeches are part of the order Archaeopteryx because they lack jaws and have a fixed number of body segments. Additionally, they produce several glandular secretions that allow them to feed on blood, including anticoagulants and anesthetics. The family Hirudinidae is named after the anticoagulant compound hirudin, which is found in leeches' saliva. This compound helps to prevent blood from clotting and allows leeches to feed for extended periods. Leeches belong to the genus Hirudo because of their unique three-jawed structure. This structure allows them to make incisions in their host's skin with ease. Finally, the most well-known species of leech is the Hirudo medicinalis. This species is often used for medicinal purposes, as it has been found to contain a variety of compounds that can help to treat conditions like high blood pressure and osteoarthritis. In conclusion, leeches are a fascinating group of creatures that have been used for medicinal purposes for centuries. Their unique feeding structure, glandular secretions, and jaw-like structure make them a unique and intriguing organism to study. We hope you enjoyed learning about the scientific classification of earthworms and leeches, and be sure to subscribe to our channel for more exciting videos like this.